How were radio waves discovered? And what does that have to do with Maxwell's equations? Well, it all started with a pessimistic young scientist named Heinrich Hertz and a contest he was too intimidated to try. And it ended with one of the most influential experiments of all time. Ready? Let's go.
Electricity.
In 1879, Germany's most famous scientist, Hermann von Helmholtz, had a great idea for the yearly Berlin Prize at the Prussian Academy of Sciences. He suggested they offer the prize to the person who could experimentally prove the existence of electromagnetic waves in space, or to experimentally prove, quote, the theory of electrodynamics, which was brought forth by Faraday and was mathematically executed by Mr. Maxwell. Helmholtz had a 22-year-old grad student that he thought was perfect for the job, Heinrich Hertz. Hertz thought about it, but decided the problem was too difficult for him. However, it put the idea in his mind, and for many years, he seriously studied the physics of electromagnetic rays. In fact, his diary had entire days with single comments like, thought about electromagnetic rays, nothing but electromagnets, worked on electromagnets all day, electromagnets still without success. And my personal favorite, because I identify with it too well, realized that, quote, most of what I have found so far is already known. He ended 1885 with, happy this year is over and hoping it will not be followed by another like it. It turned out 1886 was a far superior year, both professionally and personally. 1886 was the year Hertz met a woman named Elizabeth Dahl and fell in love. Also in the spring of that year, he was showing his equipment to his new fiancée and happened to notice a spark created a distance away from a discharging Leyden jar. Hertz was thus inspired to attempt the experiment that intimidated him 7 years earlier. In 1887, Hertz found a way to experimentally validate that light is an electromagnetic wave. How did he do that? Well, Hertz made a wave with vibrating electronics and made it travel across a room. He also later showed that his new wave would reflect off mirrors like light, bend through prisms like light, and even moves at the speed of light. Whoa, what was this new invisible light? Well, by the 1920s, these waves, which were originally called Hertzian waves, were christened radio waves. Side comment, when most people think of radio, they think of music, which is why many people think radio waves are really sound waves. This is wrong. Radio waves are invisible low-frequency light waves. To explain this better, think of records and record players. Records are discs made of vinyl with little bumps in them. When the needle bounces on the bumps, it can be used to vibrate a cone and make music. The record, therefore, is not made of music, it's made of vinyl. Radio waves are also not made of music. They are made of electromagnetic waves, just like light. However, like the vinyl records, they can have bumps in the waves that can be used to create sound. Anyway, back to Hertz. How did he make radio waves? Well, luckily for Hertz, he had a device called a spark gap generator, which would transform the power from a DC battery into bursts of very high alternating voltage and a large spark. I will describe how a spark gap generator works and how it was discovered in the next video. All Hertz had to do to create his invisible electromagnetic waves is add an antenna. So that's what he did. He added two wires to the spark gap generator with metal spheres at the end. Now he could create the waves, but he had to detect them as well. For that, he made a circular detector with a little gap in it, with the hope that if they caught the wave, they would create a little spark that he could see. Hertz could then change the size of the gap to give him a sense of the strength of the wave. This was not an easy experiment. The sparks are microscopically short. They only last about a millionth of a second. It almost seems absurd and impossible that they should be visible. But in a perfectly dark room, they are visible to an eye. Upon this thin thread hung the success of our undertaking. On November 5th, 1887, he hesitantly sent a copy of his paper to his old boss, Helmholtz. Quote, I have some misgivings about taking up your time, but this paper deals with a topic that you yourself once urged me to tackle some years ago. Helmholtz's reply was immediate. A postcard that simply said, "Bravo! We'll hand it to be printed on Thursday." Suddenly, Hertz was on a roll. His wife Elizabeth wrote his parents that the experiments were going swimmingly. He simply pulls these beautiful things out of his sleeve now. Of course, it makes him very happy, and me as well, when he tells me about it with a radiant face, although I certainly understand nothing of it. Hertz then noticed that ultraviolet light affected his results, making him the first person to notice the photoelectric effect. Then, to Hertz's surprise, he noticed that his new wave bounced off mirrors, just like visible light does. So Hertz set up a mirror parallel to the spark so the wave would bounce back and forth and make a standing wave. Standing waves are distinguished by the fact that they have points where the wave oscillates strongly, antinodes, and points where the waves destroy each other, nodes. Hertz moved his receiver between the antenna and the mirror and noted that the spark in his receiver would grow bigger at the antinodes and would disappear at the nodes. In this way, Hertz measured the wavelength of this wave. He also knew from theory that his spark gap generator produced around 70 million waves per second, or 70 million Hertz, named after Heinrich. He then used the simple wave equation that speed is frequency times wavelength. In this crude way, he measured that the speed of his wave was 320,000 kilometers per second, which is quite close to the speed of light, 300,000 kilometers per second. No, he didn't break the speed of light. He just had small inaccuracies in his measurements. Note that not only did Hertz verify that light is an electromagnetic wave, he made his own cast of special electromagnetic waves that are invisible and have transformed our world. Hertz's paper gained him almost instant international fame. William Thompson, also known as Lord Kelvin, who had influenced both Faraday and Maxwell in their theory, said, quote, "Hertz's electrical papers are a permanent monument of the splendid consummation of Faraday's ideas." Hertz got the plum position as a full professor at Bonn University and bought a beautiful house with a slight catch that had previously been used for medical experiments and might have been contaminated with chemicals. Maybe for that reason, or maybe for some other trick of fate, Hertz began to have migraines in the July of 1892. He was diagnosed with a blood disorder and died on January 1st of 1894 when he was only 36 years old, leaving his distraught wife, Elizabeth, and two young daughters, aged 2 and 6. It's tempting to think that if it wasn't for his untimely death, Hertz might have invented wireless telegraph or maybe even radio communication. However, at the time, he didn't see any practical use of his invention, saying, "These experiments are, quote, of no use whatsoever. This is just an experiment that proves Maestro Maxwell was right. We have these mysterious electromagnetic waves that we cannot see with the naked eye, but they are there." A few months after Hertz's death, a 20-year-old Irish-Italian man named Marconi read an obituary of Heinrich Hertz and became obsessed with creating long-distance wireless telegraphs. However, he might not have gotten very far with the spark gap generator, as it was too weak to transmit a signal across the ocean. Luckily, 5 years later, Nikola Tesla went to the World's Fair in Paris and heard about the miracle of Hertz's experiment. Tesla then started tinkering with the spark gap generator and ended up inventing the Tesla coil. But what exactly is a Tesla coil? How does it work and why is it important? Well, I'll tell you next time on The Secret History of Electricity.
Electricity, 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 electricity.
Thanks for watching my video. If you haven't seen them yet, I recommend watching the one on how Faraday came up with the idea of electromagnetic waves and how Maxwell came up with the math for it. Also, check out the next one on Tesla coil. Should be good. Okay, have a nice day.